Thank you so much for joining us today. We are the Career Development Team at Macaulay Honors College. My name is Janina Crispin. I'm the Associate Director of Career Development.
And I'm Jamie Rudin, the Career Program Coordinator. Thank you so much for listening to our 5-minute resume tips presentation. We're going to cover 3 tricks, tips, and makeover tactics to make a resume shine. So many of you have maybe never heard of the term ATS, which stands for Application Tracking System. This technology comes in different forms and is commonly used by mid to large sized companies. Think about it. Companies like Google, Facebook, Twitter are hugely popular tech companies. They get thousands of applications a day. There's just not enough manpower in the world for their HR team to look at every single resume and application. Thus, ATS was born. This tool scans your resume for key terms, length of stay at companies, which tallies your years of experience, and hard and soft skills, making sure you format your resume correctly and implement those key terms are vital to passing through ATS and making it to the next step of a human to review and make the judgment call if you'd be a good fit for the position.
As Jamie mentioned, it's incredibly important to format your resume correctly. You want to make sure that your resume is clear and organized, making it as easy as possible for the recruiter or hiring manager to get valuable information about your skills and experience from it. Make sure to include your education, relevant coursework, work or research experience, leadership or extracurricular activities, community service, and of course, skills. The order really depends on how much information you have available. Just be sure to include your most prized or impressive experiences at the top to make the best impression from the start. I want to be able to provide 3 sample resumes, and each of them will highlight a different format for that particular industry. The business and finance resume is really the most general that can apply to a lot of different industries, but we wanted to highlight, if you'll notice, that the resume is clearly divided into different sections. It is also highlighting leadership roles, and the skills are subdivided into categories. So that's technical skills, certification, training, languages, and activities. With the next example of a technical resume, you're really trying to highlight the technical skills that you possess. So you want to make sure that you're putting towards the top of the resume, your operating systems, your software, your hardware, your computer languages, or anything that's relevant to your particular field. And make sure to subcategorize those as well. Then you're also inserting very valuable technical vocabulary into your descriptions of projects and experiences. And overall, you want to make sure that you're maintaining a reverse chronological order, which also applies to all other resumes. But in this particular example, we wanted to make sure that you noticed that. Then last but not least, we have a graphic design resume. And so these are the most exciting for me because this is where you could really add color. Most other resumes will really discourage you from using color. However, in graphic design resumes, that's really seen as an extension of your portfolio. You're really showcasing your design skills within your resume right here. So you want to make sure that you're really inserting your own brand and your personality into that, and that you're showcasing your creativity. Then you're also going to include your skills and highlight those with the appropriate legend. And last but not least, you're also putting down your related work experience. Unfortunately, graphic design resumes are not compatible with ATS, but that's not something that graphic designers need to worry about.
So we've learned about ATS and the different ways of formatting a resume. It depends on our career trajectory. Now it's about getting to the meat of the resume, bullets. Bullet points allow the reader to easily digest the tasks you've accomplished and how you've added value to your current or previous organizations. When writing a bullet, I wind up with this key formula. Action verb, what you did, how you did it, why you did it. And I like to say for bonus points, quantify. Now it's important to diversify your action verbs as we not only want to show off your skills, but your expansive vocabulary. So every bullet should not start with taught or created or managed or assisted, popular ones I see from my students and alums. So let's do a quick example. A bad example would be assistant supervisor in presentation. Updated with the formula, presented alongside the director of development to our company of 50 employees highlighting our research, findings, and recommendations to improve outreach to the key demographic. This practice is important to implement, but will take some time to get used to. But once you hit on each point of the bullet formula, you will look so good on your resume. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to our lessons of resume, and we hope you have a great day. Thank you.
Bye.